them now in terms of their interest in kind of coordinated water resource management and land use and some of the things that they're doing. And we have certainly have a great partnership with them, and I know they'll highlight a bit of that as part of this presentation. So I'd like to introduce, well, before I do that, I'm sorry, I'm going to completely mess this up, but I was reminded by somebody that the use of the room as we left this morning is done. So if you left stuff in that room, it's been removed. There's a table back at check-in that has the binders and your portfolios and the things that you might have left. We'll have our staff there to help you retrieve what you might have left behind. So don't panic. So I'd like to introduce Kate Williams with the California Water Foundation. Kate has worked very closely with me and a number of others in the development of the Sustainable Groundwater Management Act and to develop funding strategies that we've put to work here in the Kings Basin. Kate's got experience prior to the foundation with the legislature in numerous roles in resource management in the legislature. She's actually worked on water legislation with then Assemblymember John Laird, now the Secretary of Resources for the state of California, and then Assemblymember Jared Huffman, who's now a congressman representing the Bay Area. Kate's been involved in the CalFed process and worked prior positions with the Department of Water Resources. I invited Kate to kind of explain why the foundation cares about what we do and what their interests are, and so her presentation will focus on that, and Kate, we'd love to hear from you. Thank you.
Thank you. So yeah, Dave asked me to come down here and explain who we are and why we're involved, and we were actually mentioned a fair amount today, so I think I'll make this quick so we can all get on the road or back to work or play hooky, whatever you wanted to do. I just closed it down, I think. Some down some of the barriers and move the issue forward. are starting out in LA. We've been there for a while working on stormwater issues, and we'll probably expand that. In the Kings Basin, we've also, as Dave said, we've been working for a couple of years, but we're also going to advance that and work with local leaders and interests to see where we can help make a difference to move towards sustainability and integration and work around the edges. And it's no accident that we picked Kings. It's Kings because we have a rock star in the area, and we also have Fresno County, which is a top producer, leading agricultural county. So it really is a place to test and try out and advance sustainable water management and with an agricultural base. So you've heard a lot about 2014 in some of the prior discussions, but we also have this, that the drought really led a lot of the changes and influenced the attention in Sacramento. It influenced the governor's office, the administration, and the legislature. And so we saw that things were coming, and that's one of the main reasons we got involved in order to help shape and bring as many stakeholders to the table. But we've already gone through the Water Action Plan, which is a key document that looks not just at groundwater or not just at the tunnels, but at all the comprehensive steps that the administration and state should look at to move to sustainable water management. The bond was historic. We hope it passes next week. I hope it passes. And then the historic groundwater legislation. All really were driven from the attention early, over a year ago, getting in the media from the drought and the impacts on the groundwater. So why are we involved in groundwater? And this kind of gives you the context. We see it that it's such a key part of sustainable water management in many areas of the state that rely on it. 40% of the supply in the average year, 60% in a dry year like this. It's really gone up. And it's also a very flexible source for storage. It can be a ground cover. So we saw it as very important, and then we also saw all the problems that everybody's been talking about. So when we see an important issue and a problem associated, we ask people how can we help? And so some of the problems that you've heard about were the same problems that we researched, we invested in, and wanted to understand, because one of the problems with moving groundwater policy forward was that no one understood it. You can't see it. It's hard to explain it. It's hard to see the impacts, of course. So we invested in various aspects of this to bring that to the attention and help people understand the extent of the problem. But the list is long in terms of the impact from overdraft, and it varies by region, but those impacts keep hitting the press even weekly in this area. It's still going. So what do we do? We do partnerships. Demonstrations is one of our areas of investment, and as Dave said, we've been working with KRCB. We've also been with Sonoma County Water Agency, Yuba County Water Agency, and Upper San Gabriel Valley MWD in Southern California. Some of these projects are, you can call them projects, it's like building coalitions. We might actually convene meetings just to get, as you did today, get the people talking together about solutions across the table, and then move them forward. So if they want to develop the solutions, they have all the people at the table. We're also doing demo projects on the ground. But a big part of this is building partnerships so that we can learn from the local areas, those actual water managers and land use planners, about what works and doesn't work in their area. So this is a picture much like a contour map. The darker areas are the highest areas of subsidence. This is just over, I think, 5 years, 2007 to 2011, up to 4 feet in those areas of subsidence. And we do this because it's just to demonstrate that it's still an ongoing problem. Everybody knows about it, but this helped kind of bring the information to light. Second report, we wanted to look at, there's a lot of good groundwater management planning going on, but how is it overall across the state for these groundwater management plans? These are the SB 1938 plans, AB 3030 plans you've heard about. So these plans go into DWR if they want to get a grant, but they're not scored, they're not really evaluated. They're just, are they done or not done? And so we hired RMC and a team of hydrogeologists to inform that process and review the 120 plans, and the results weren't so good. There are some really outstanding plans, but on average, the score was 22 out of 45. We have not publicized these scores. We've aggregated the data, and it's available on our report. But over 50% of the basins don't have plans. Some of these plans haven't been updated since 2000. So they're not really informing management if they're very old. And there's data lacking, and there's lack of detail in their basic management objectives. We compared what was required or listed in the law compared to what was in the plans, and it wasn't very complete. And so what this told us is the current status quo for planning is not working. That system of just putting grants out in front of someone to do a good groundwater management plan still wasn't working. It made a difference when 1938 passed, SB 1938, but not enough to really move the needle. So we saw that new tools and authorities and new management plans might be needed as part of this legislation. The last research is not on problem definition, but on solution. So we have looked at this innovative idea, still needs to be tested, actually on the ground in Terra Nova Farms, which is, Don probably recognizes his area right there. Thank you for the photo. But we're doing a research study with UC Davis and RMC, and in cooperation with some of the counties, looking at these three counties and regions on the east side about what their suitability is for recharge. do the same thing we did with bringing the policy forward, is we want to look at what are the tools that can be used to help implement the groundwater legislation. We're supportive of the broad comprehensive approach that's in the California Water Action Plan, and Prop 1 bringing funding to all types of water management. But we're looking to be, I think governance is going to be one of our biggest challenges with the groundwater legislation. It's being kind of saying it's a food fight, but it's also a challenge. It was basically the idea is give locals the choice of how to make it work in their area. We could not come up in Sacramento with one system for governance of the groundwater, and it was very clear they wanted local choice. So what's local choice is now flipped as a food fight. It still is a great opportunity to get in and bring the counties and the cities and the water managers together to solve groundwater management. So,
I'll end
there. Thank you.
Do you have any questions, Kate?
Easy questions. Thanks.
Well, we started late. We're ending early. We do have a couple of minutes. Does anybody have any questions that didn't get addressed this morning that you feel that you'd like to raise? Or are you just enjoying your lunch and thought of getting out of here a few minutes earlier? Okay, well, let me just wrap up. First of all, thanks very much to Kate and the Foundation for their role in this, and thanks to all of you for participating in this. Hopefully, my major question is our mission accomplished? Did we continue the dialogue? And help some of you understand how integrated planning and how the Sustainable Groundwater Management Act present opportunities and challenges for us, and maybe think a little bit about what your role is in whatever capacity you are in kind of moving some of these issues ahead. I'd like to also thank our speakers for the day, and I know that Dr. Hanick had to leave just moments ago, but appreciate very much her role in speaking and facilitating the panel, as well as our designated interloper, Jay Jaspers. We thank you for coming all the way from Sonoma County, and then Derek, Bernard, Luke, and Eric. Appreciate all of that on the panel. I might mention the sponsors earlier. We're going to close with just, again, a recognition of them and thank them for their support of this, and wish you all a great